Did you hear the word of the Lord this morning? It's time to see a harvest for this nation. It's time to see a harvest for your life of the benefits of the kingdom of God, which is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And there's a benefit that God gives us of freedom. Now, I started thinking about this word, and I thought about an alignment with also the word kingdom. Okay? Freedom and kingdom. So when we talk about the kingdom of God, the word, the etymology of the word kingdom is the word king and then dom, which is the Latin for domain. And a domain is the territory under the rulership of a government. So when you talk about the kingdom of God, you're talking about a domain that is under the rulership of the king. Okay? That's the kingdom of God. How many know that we ought to have the kingdom of God in our life, the domain, the rulership of the king in our life? So when we look at the word freedom, it's the same root word with dome, meaning the territory or the domain. So it is the place or the territory under the rulership and government of freedom. You know, that's one of the reasons that they call this nation the land of the free. How many understand? A lot of people struggle with that freedom. And there were some dark parts of our history where not everybody was free. But when we make the declaration, we are the land of the free, there was something in the domain of this territory that had to start lining up with freedom until freedom was produced in the life of every single human being in this nation. I recognize that when our founders wrote the Declaration of Independence, that we had slavery in this land. And they said, this is the declaration that all men are created equal. How many understand that decree that they made before God pushed our nation until the time where we started making sure that all men were created equal under God? You see the effects of a decree? How many understand there was no reality to that declaration in the beginning, but it pushed our nation and is continuing to push our nation to a place where we are experiencing that all men are created equal and the freedom, the land of the free for all that come here. I can tell you, my husband and I have traveled over 60 nations in the earth. Our nation is not a perfect nation, but I can tell you it's the best nation on earth. No matter where we go, we see beautiful lands, we see beautiful places, we see lots of amazing things, and every single time we think, oh my God, thank God we live in America. If you don't have that gratitude for the nation that we're living in, I'm telling you, God has brought us to a place that is covenanting with him. So we're going to talk about that a little bit this morning. Look at what the word says. John 8:36 says, so if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. Let me do that without the squeak in my voice. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. Let me say it again. If the Son sets you free, then you will be, say it out, scream it out, free indeed. Shout out, free indeed. Galatians 5:1 says, it was for freedom that Christ has set us free. It was for freedom. See, Jesus came and paid a price so that we could be free. Now, I recognize that we're coinciding this benefit of the kingdom of God about freedom with the weekend that we celebrate the birth of this nation, the freedom that comes from this nation. Our nation is 243 years old this weekend. Can we thank the Lord for that? Amen. 243 years old. And I remember a statement that was made by a general. I wish that I would have written his name down. But I heard him say this at the very beginning of the Iraq War. He said this. He said, we Americans must be careful that we do not love peace more than freedom. And I think the church needs to hear that message. We need to understand that we've got to contend for freedom. We've got to fight for freedom. We've got to fight for freedom from the oppression of the enemy. We've got to fight against injustice. We've got to fight for the cause of the kingdom of God. We've got to fight for the word of God to be made real in our lives. How many feel like you've ever had to fight to see God's promises come to pass? What are we fighting? We're fighting the devil. We're fighting our flesh. We're fighting doubt. We're fighting unbelief. We're fighting things, but freedom has to be contended for. And we've got to recognize a very important truth about freedom. Number one, freedom is not free. Freedom is not free. Somebody has paid a price for your freedom. I'm always terrified of those. Have you ever seen Jesse Waters when he goes out, or used to be Jay Leno, would go out on the street and would interview people and say, "What are we celebrating on the 4th of July?" Have y'all seen those? I'm always like, when my children were little, I would always sit them down and like teach them after I would see one of those things to make sure that my children would never be on television saying that we fought China in the Revolutionary War. Seriously, that's what we heard last night. Who did we fight in the Revolutionary War? China? What was the date of the Declaration of Independence? 1984? Nope, way off. 1884? Nope, way off. Come on, guys. We have to understand and never forget our history. I want you to understand our history is why we contend for this nation. Because this nation, though not perfect, was dedicated to be a place where the kingdom of God could come and begin to manifest here on planet Earth. And those that signed the Declaration of Independence, which is what we celebrate on July the 4th, is the launching the Declaration of Independence. I want you to understand that those 56 men that signed the Declaration of Independence actually knew that they were signing their death warrant. Let's bring it back into perspective. They knew that to write the Declaration of Independence was to rebel against the oppressive government of the British government, the English government that was oppressing them, and they wrote something called the Declaration of Independence. I think we need to rewrite it today and say we need a Declaration of Dependence because we need to depend on God. But we were making a Declaration of Independence. And of the 56 men that signed the Declaration of Independence, let me just show you the price that they paid for birthing this nation. Five of them were captured and tortured before the British, before they died. 12 of them had their homes ransacked and burned to the ground. 2 lost their sons in the war. 1 had 2 sons captured and killed. 9 of them fought and died from wounds or the hardships of war. Carter Braxton of Virginia was a wealthy planter and trader, and he saw his ship swept away from the sea by the British Navy. He sold his home to pay his debts, and he died poor. Thomas McKean was forced to move his family almost constantly because he was so hounded by the British. He served in Congress without pay, and he died in poverty because he was paying a price. Thomas Nelson, his home was seized by the British at the Battle of Yorktown and used as a command post. He urged General George Washington to open fire on it. He said, "Open fire on my home." And his home was completely destroyed. And this man died bankrupt. So they were willing to pay a price. They weren't willing to just say, "Hey, this is a great idea." They were willing to say, "You know what? If it costs my life, if it takes the life of my family, if it takes every penny that I've got, I'm willing to lay it down for a cause." Come on, God is looking for that kind of courageous people today that will begin to take up a kingdom cause. That will begin to take up a cause for the kingdom of God to advance, to take up a cause for liberty to be seen in this nation again. We understand that freedom isn't free. Somebody paid a price. And in the kingdom of God, we know that it was Jesus who paid the ultimate price for our spiritual freedom.